So you understand BSc and ISI, you understand ISI takes PA as 2 hours, then break, then PB another 2 hours. BSc is a at a straight 2 hours exam. MCQ questions. What are the different first areas? I am coming to that. JNE. Why depend on the questions? Basically are the questions from international trade, little bit of micro, hardly macro, and development economics and very elementary mathematics. JNU MA in economics. JNU MA in economics orientation is macro as well as many information based questions, and those information pertain to not only the Indian economy but world economy. For example, when is LIC established? For example, who wrote the book on British rule in India? So these are the types of questions often come, and some students often tell us that we are uncomfortable because these are not economics questions, this doesn't test our analytical skill. But anyway, that is the kind of pattern. Now if you do that, the performance of the students as a whole in these competitive exams, what do you get? The data speak out, and speak out very loudly. In our times, of course, 1996 onwards, ISI has started the MSP program. We passed out before 1996. At least 2005-06, what I found is that a lot of students from Calcutta, and by Calcutta I do not mean St. Javier's, Jadavpur, or for example, residency. Students from different colleges. Different colleges, even students from Bordhaman colleges, cracked in this competitive exam, 2006-08. Then what we find nowadays? What we find nowadays is a very shocking picture. The shocking from the point of view of the West Bengal and Calcutta in particular. If you just go through the list, you'll be finding names who are no way related to colleges or universities of Calcutta or West Bengal in particular. 80% of the the first list come from the Delhi-based colleges. Why so? Why we are lagging behind? I often ask myself this question. That exactly what went wrong with us? Is it that sudden fall in the quality of teaching of Calcutta University colleges? Is it the sudden fall or deep fall, plummeting fall in the quality of students or something else? Actually what happens particularly in the teaching learning process of Delhi colleges is that right at the semester, beginning of the semester, they receive a study materials. They in fact do not know from what sources or what book these xeroxes are given up. They receive a study materials. This for each paper. These study materials are meticulously taught. And then right from the day go, that means right from semester one, they go for their competitive exams preparations, be that IAS, be that MBA, or be that this type of exams which I am talking about. So by the end of the third year, they are exposed to variety of problems, variety of new ideas. And another thing is that their self-study and also general study is quite higher scale compared to our students. And this is something which is unnerving for me as a teacher. For example, I mean just during this Puja vacation, I went to Delhi and I had some friends of DSC and ISI. So I met them, and what they told me, the shocking fact is that poor economics have not read by students of Calcutta, but it has been read by, for example, the Delhi students. For example, the good economics for hard times. Now, if you look at the good economics for hard times, Kastrova and Abhijit Binod Banerjee, what you find is an interesting thing. Not a single equation written, not a single statistical exercise done. What they have done is this. They have started with basic, very fundamental issues, questions that people are facing in their everyday life. They raise that particular issue. They identify that particular problem. Put them in a given context and then proceed to analyze how to, explain the problem with a probable answer, with a possible solution. That solution may be theoretical, may have a close connection with the policy making, etc. If you read these types of books, what actually happens is that your knowledge domain increases, your thinking ability increases, and your problem solving ability also increases. Ultimately, at the end of the day, when you are taking these exams, you will be, what will be tested is your problem solving ability. And problem solving ability, you mean, you know, see, given a particular problem, you have to understand the angularities of the problem and what way you can easily, you know, approach the problem. How to achieve it? More problems you solve, more greater confidence that you can achieve. Now see, I am just giving you a couple of examples here, just to understand that you don't need mathematical derivations of 2 to 3 pages to solve a particular problem. Let me begin with, I think that Kaushik Gupta wrote something on both, so I am using the same particular utility function, u vx1 plus x1. V prime positive, V double prime negative. This is what function? See, this is non-linear with respect to x1, linear with respect to x1. So this is what type of preference? Quasi-linear preference. Now, you have to prove that the interim effect on x1 is 0. How to prove it? Very simple. What will be the first order condition? Since there is a non-linearity part, mu x1 by mu x2 equal to p1 by p2 will hold. You know, in case of perfect substitutes, mu x1 by mu x2 equal to p1 by p2 do not hold. But here it will be holding. So mu x1 is v prime function of x1, x2 is 1, p1 by p2. Now look at it carefully. Just look at the first condition carefully. What are the endogenous variables x1 and x2? What are the parameters m, p1 and p2? Look at equation 1. Do you find any m here? Answer no. So this is one equation involving one unknown. What is that unknown? X1. So X1 depends on what? P1 by P2. Does X1 depend on M? Answer no, because there is no M here. So straight away from here you are getting what? X1. Once you get X1, then from the budget equation what you are getting? You are getting? You are getting, tell me, X2. So the interim effect on X1 is 0. So when Genu, particularly the question from Genu, they get a, you know, this question, then a little bit of change in question, man income changes, prices changes, and they are giving options. Now if you try to work out all these options, it will be taking 10 to 15 minutes time. But if you know this basic logic, all the results, the three results related to the same question will be solved in 2 minutes. So that means actually you have to develop your intuitive skill. And this intuitive skill, once again I am telling you, is not easy to come by unless and until you actually practice it. Another question, this is a question from us. The question is, suppose tax rate goes up, what will be the effect on national saving? That is the question, tax rate goes up, what will be the effect on national saving? What is national saving? You know, personal saving plus, that is private saving, plus, tell me, public saving, which you often call budget surplus. So here, what is the tax structure? Small t into y. Question is, small t goes up, what will happen to national saving? This is the question. There are two situations given, you have to find out its effect on national saving. In one case, investment is autonomous, fixed. In the second case, investment is a function of Y. So these are the two cases. Now what you can do? You write down the consumption, you write down the, you know, the commodity market equilibrium. Try to work it out. Then try to find out national saving. It will take at least one test, definite algebraic calculation, 1.5 page, and it will take, say, for example, 5 to 10 minutes time.